Interstellar is a visual masterpiece, but the most spectacular aspect of the movie is that those jaw-dropping shots of black holes and wormholes are the most realistic depictions of these phenomena man has ever created. Thanks to a $200 million budget only a proven blockbuster filmmaker can command, director Christopher Nolan's team had the resources to create impeccably detailed computer-generated simulations of space-time events that had previously only existed in highly complex equations. To achieve this task, Nolan's visual effects director Paul Franklin used the mathematical genius of leading astrophysicist Kip Thorne to generate algorithms that guided the effects software. In fact, it was the astrophysicist himself who conceptualized the film, along with producer Linda Obst, who Thorne worked with on 1997's Contact. Thorne's passionate about explaining the mind-bending ideas of relativity to the general public, and was thrilled when he saw the final result. The visuals are so powerful, so accurate, that Thorne's planning on publishing two academic journal articles based on the computer renderings of a black hole used in the film, which led to a new scientific discovery, that light temporarily trapped around the black hole produced an unexpectedly complex fingerprint pattern and a glowing accretion disk that appeared above, below, and in front of the black hole. Quote, "I never expected that," Thorne says. "It was just amazing," end quote. No one knew exactly what a black hole would look like until they actually built one for the film. Some of the single frames in these sequences took 100 hours to render. The entire movie is 800 terabytes of data. Another thing that makes a lot of the science behind the film realistic is the script. Steven Spielberg, who was originally set to direct, hired Chris Nolan's brother, the screenwriter Jonathan Nolan, to write the movie. Nolan worked on it for 4 years, even studying relativity at the California Institute of Technology to learn the science. When Christopher Nolan took over as director, he emphasized the human element of the picture and even codenamed the film Flora's Letter because it's essentially a letter to his daughter, says star Jessica Chastain. To film the scenes set on a dying, dusty earth, the production planted a 500-acre cornfield in rural Alberta. Then they burned it all down in a manufactured apocalypse. Nolan was inspired by Stanley Kubrick's 2001 A Space Odyssey in many ways, including the one powerful image idea, which led to Nolan's ambitious use of longer shots. Like Nolan's Batman trilogy before it, Interstellar is shot on 70mm IMAX film and is, according to the director, quote, "all about the theatrical experience, getting audiences to see it as an experience in the theater with other people," end quote. That's why the movie will open to the widest ever release for a film, in 670 IMAX theaters around the planet. Thanks for watching. Share this video if you thought it was interesting, and make sure you subscribe to The Daily Conversation for our next informative daily video. And click on the screen to check out our video running down the most promising energy sources of the future and interesting facts about the last highly successful space-themed film, Gravity.